My God, Shaq's in the house.
Hello.
We are going live.
Hello. Okay, excellent. I've made it in time. Sorry
And we
for
are live.
call ran late.
Very
Call
good.
ran late. Sorry.
And we are live. No, that's totally fine. We are live. Hello, everybody. We are.
Hello,
Hello. We are live. Welcome to 30 Questions, live on YouTube. Here we are with Zoom with our guest. I don't even know how to introduce you. The genial, the multi-hyphenate comedian, actor, quiz master, B school whiz, random person, Mr. Kumar Varun.
thank you, Rohan. Honored to be here. Like I said,
Arey,
anything with you and Shaq is fun, so really
it is
looking forward.
always, I have realized this is true though, we have always had a good time every single
Can I
time.
just say, Rohan, since we have KV here, let's change the format to 30 questions and just have KV ask us 30 questions.
That's just that just be a regular Thursday night then. That's just regular
That's
Thursday
the
night
quiz.
then. This is
That's
regular Thursday
every
night.
single morning. That's my routine. I get up, I put
Yeah.
three questions to two of you.
That is, yeah,
Thank
that
you.
is literally morning routine. And I remember in the middle when I was like traveling and on the road at 7 in the morning, I was awake to answer those questions. It was a rare occasion that I was up at 7 in the morning to answer your questions, KV, and I felt so good that that was a thing that we could do. Zakir Chair OP says Kaushik Chatterjee.
Oh man, it's amazing how the entire audience knows every corner of everyone's house throughout lockdown.
Yeah,
I've been
yeah.
one corner and they're like, I know ye kiska ghar hai.
Of
Like,
course.
I KV, because I'm just like, where is your bookshelf?
Because, yeah, I'm not at my house.
Yeah,
That's what I
exactly.
figured,
Like,
obviously.
it's weird. It's weird to see you without your bookshelf. Like,
Yeah.
standard quizzing background is absent. And that's this thing. So, Shax, I was talking to KV about this, and I asked people what the theme should be for today. And because it's KV, the answer that popped up very, very often was books. That we should ask people about books, that we should answer 30 questions about books, because their logic is KV ko हर चीज के बारे में बहुत कुछ आता है, बहुत स्मार्ट आदमी है, which is true. वो बहुत बुक्स पढ़ता रहेगा आदमी, and that is also true. I can also say that one of the nicest things that KV does after the quiz tournament is he sends as a sort of informal prize a book related to the subject that the quiz was about.
Buddy, I
And
would like to point out that I have not gotten my
because,
book
brother, because
for winning two quizzes.
I'll tell you later why. Because I'm now trying to follow the YouTube timeline, so I don't want.
So eventually at some point like that. Fair, fair, fair.
Sorry, I just felt very left out, and
That's not
I'm
at
a
all.
man who wears his emotions on his Adidas sleeves.
Yeah, and when you feel like someone doesn't give you, it feels particularly because books are such lovely gifts, right?
Also,
Books.
those quiz victories are precious
Oh, those quiz
to
victories
me.
are very precious to me. Genuinely, some of the most fulfillment I have had this year in this lockdown, like achievements. So definitely that. Shall we get started, friends? Wait, no, wait, before we get started, Mr. Shakya, you have an announcement to
It's.
make. You have been doing
I
things.
have an announcement to make. So I've started a newsletter. I'm going to be doing weekly humor columns like I used to do in Sun Times. If you followed my blog, you'll know that. It's called Stupid is Maximus 2.0. It's on a platform called Substack. Yes, there it is. Oh, काफी स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स कट टू
सर सर सर
विजुअल्स
सीख रहे हैं हम
सर
थोड़ा
सर
बहुत
सर
ओ
बहुत बहुत अच्छा
सीख रहे
आपने
सर
ओबीएस के
ओबीएस थोड़ा क्या
तो
करें अभी
बेसिकली आप सब्सक्राइब करो और आपके पास इनबॉक्स में सीधा आ जाएगा प्लस आई वांट टू डू मंथली लाइव इवेंट्स यू गेट एक्सेस टू ऑल ऑफ दैट आई वुड रेकमेंड नाउ बिकॉज देर आर सम टीथिंग ट्रबल्स आई वुड रेकमेंड गेटिंग द मंथली सब्सक्रिप्शन ए एंड
ओके
बी इफ एट ऑल यू फेस एनी पेमेंट इश्यूज बिकॉज इट्स अ यूएस बेस्ड प्लेटफॉर्म सो अपना बैंकिंग और उनका बैंकिंग देयर इज सम
हाँ
डिले
हाँ
हैपनिंग
हाँ हाँ
इन पेमेंट्स ऑल द सॉल्यूशंस टू द पेमेंट फिक्सेस आर ऑन माय इंस्टाग्राम देयर ऑन माय हाइलाइट्स देयर ऑन माय स्टोरीज इफ एट ऑल यू फेस इट मोस्ट ट्रांजैक्शंस आर ओके इफ एट ऑल यू फेस इट जस्ट गो लुक देयर और ईमेल मी एंड इफ यू लाइक गुड राइटिंग गुड कॉमेडी एंड डम
Yeah, you
जोक्स
spent so
कमिंग टू
much
योर
time on the
इनबॉक्स
troubleshooting. I was worried you were not going to mention the part that, like, Ashish Shakya is legit, like, I think the like humor column gold standard that all of us have
अरे कहाँ यार
like read over like the last
वेरी
decade. So
वेरी नाइस ऑफ
like
यू टू से
screenshot the hell out of
कमिंग फ्रॉम
this
या
and
प्लीज स्क्रीनशॉट
like
इट यस
please screenshot it
100%
and then this thing. And now we would go back to let us
send me
begin.
fan story about
Sorry.
my fan story of Shakya's column so many times that I don't feel like
No,
repeating.
don't do it now. We
No,
did
please do,
it
please
on
do, please
but you
do.
did it on the last one, yeah, with Sapan on your own channel. You
Repeat
did
that.
it.
That's why I'll just say it's the best humor column that I've ever read. And I used to look forward to that column in Hindustan Times every single week. I did not know anything about Indian stand-up comedy. I did not know about AIB. I did not know anything else. I knew that this guy who writes this column this one day every week, and it's to look forward to every single week. And I can't wait for it to come back.
That is true. And I know that there's a lot of people that cannot wait for that to happen, because like, I feel like this in general, this newsletter has been coming for a long time, Shax. Like, it was fucking due.
Guys, jokes.
It was fucking due. Just like,
it was due. Just
get out of your system. And if you've learned anything from On Air with AIB, just don't let your first newsletter be about whistleblowers, because no one will watch.
I don't know. India mein baki hai whistleblowers. I think humne pakad nahi liye sare. Like Pokemon, gotta catch them all. Like,
yeah, gotta catch them all. Caught them all also. Caught them all also. So without further ado, wait, hang on. Let me
whistleblower are on roads of UP.
Oh, hilarious. Oh, Guru.
This joke will not be there.
Oh, Guru. No, get it all out of the way here only.
Yeah.
Yahan pe nikal de. Newsletter mein mat do. Yes. All right. 30 questions about books. We will now start all the way from Direct KB back on the chain. I'll need to get moderators to help with this. Okay. We can start with a very simple one, which is, Advait wants to know, what's a book that you will always recommend?
Wow.
Like, what's a book where it's like, you know, some books you're like, oh, it depends on your taste, depends on this, depends on that. But there's some books that are just like, boss, if you don't enjoy this, then this, you just don't like reading. Like,
again, it's the same question as what is your favorite book, which is very hard to answer. But I feel like because I read this young and the weight of it was magnificent when I first read it as a youngster, was, I think, The Godfather.
Yes.
Which is, yeah, it's a beautiful book. It says so much, and it introduces such an interesting world. And man, it's obviously such an empire at this point.
And what a sprawl, right? Like, what a sprawl that book has. Like,
yeah, and the cultural impact it had, the story behind, well, Mario Puzo wrote it when he was like in his 50s.
Yeah.
You know, struggling and broke. And I mean, there's so much. And just the way that the representation of the mafia in that book has influenced real life dons and all of that. It's a very interesting, magnificent, powerful, powerful story. And yeah.
And it's also impossible to put down. Like, that story, it is impossible to put down, right? For all its, like, it's great literature and all of that, but also impossible to put down.
And you will remember, I think the last 30 to 50 pages are something else.
Oh, God.
When the retribution starts happening and,
Oof, man.
And I think one of the few books where if you watch the movie, you will not be disappointed.
Oh, yeah. You can do both. They're like companion pieces. You can absolutely do both. Yeah. Like, no problem at all.
One of those books which not only has like quotable quotes, so many of them, like keep your friends close, etc., etc. But like, there is, now that we have worked enough, we also understand things like character arc and all, and it's beautiful. Sonny, Michael, even Tom Hagen, like everyone, like how blood is thicker than water. There's just so many themes.
So many things, man.
And when you read it as a youngster, you don't know all of this. You don't understand story. You don't understand, you know, the reluctant hero who has to take on the mantle. When you grow up, the trope becomes familiar. It's the same thing as, you know, you'll see in a lot of mafia movies where there are two characters, like the hot-headed one will die and the reluctant bookish
hero will have to take over, basically.
So these things you don't understand. And then, I mean,
I was also not expecting like the stuff with Apollonia to go down the way it did. Like, that was what the hell, man? What is this book? It was Game of Thrones before Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
KV, what's a book you'll always recommend?
Oh, man. Yeah. Like, you said it so well when you said this, just so much context when you recommend a book. As in, what all have you read so far? What is the kind of book that you want to read next? But yeah, so the answer is very difficult. But I always recommend Mahabharata to everyone.
It is a beautiful book. It is actually a brilliant story, the Mahabharata.
Yeah.
Which retelling or which version?
So I would recommend anyone to start with very basic. There's a C. Rajagopalachari version of Mahabharata, which is very, like, very thin. And it's just, I think it does justice to the original. So it doesn't have many interpretation or different perspective, because Mahabharata has been rewritten so many times.
Yeah,
from a property perspective, from this perspective, from that perspective, like Palace of Illusion, there are just so many interpretations.
Yeah,
but I would
want
everyone, especially an Indian, to read Mahabharata, because, like, I think someone said, if you understand Mahabharata, you understand India. And also in terms of the book, like, the book has everything. The story has everything. There's tragedy. There is, like, again, like I said, character arcs. There are backstories. There is how, like, stories converge at a single place. There's of course Bhagavad Gita in the middle. So there are just so many things
in the middle, just casually. Yeah, just casually, there. So, like, you know you're a great book when like the Gita is just like a sub book within your book, right?
Yeah.
You know, that's so interesting. I've not read this, and I've not read the other newer versions that have come out with, you know, different interpretations.
The reason I really love the Mahabharata is because what happens with so many mythological stories is that they get focused on dealing with the lives and affairs of the gods and these sort of ideal people, right? The Mahabharata is first and foremost a story of people. Yeah. It's a story of some very flawed, very deeply warped in some ways people. These are people who have been twisted by their own lives, twisted by the way their familial lives have gone, twisted by the way things have happened over generations. And the whole book is just a series of consequences of those actions playing out. Yeah. And as a result of that, it's staggering to watch. And unlike a lot of other epics also, it doesn't really have the neatest resolution in that sense. It's messy. People are left in weird places. People are left in hurtful places. People are left in interesting places. And that's what makes it such a fascinating book. The Devdutt Patnaik version is also beautiful, by the way. If you want a super easy way in, it's called Jaya and it's fantastic.
I've only very long ago read the Ashok Banker Ramayana series.
That was also
which
brilliant.
I enjoyed. I read when it was like 20 or 21. I really enjoyed it because I was very unfamiliar with the story. When I was a kid, so for me, it was like reading an action adventure. And it is.
And he's written it as one, right? He's written it as an adventure story, basically.
It's an action adventure, like you could imagine, like a very, I mean, Lord of the Rings kind of comparisons come to mind, right? Like, but obviously, very different context. So that was fun because the plot is great. Mujhe pata hi tha, there's demons, there's action, there's, you know, villains and heroes and fighting and like mystery and suspense and spying and like lots of crazy, crazy stuff.
I would, from a plot perspective, place the Mahabharata over the Ramayana.
Awesome.
Like, just in terms of the sprawl of the plot. Like, there are characters in, like, the Mahabharata where, like, you're in despair sometimes. It's like watching Game of Thrones where you're almost like, why is this guy the baddie? Yeah. Like, why? What a character. Why is this guy? I wish I could just undeservedly love this guy. Like, because what a story, right? So, yeah, lots of that happening in the Mahabharata. So, yeah, Mahabharata and the Godfather. I can see the parallels.
Yeah. I just want to add to what Rohan said that, you know, Mahabharata is so practical and flawed. Like, compared to Ramayana, Ramayana is a story of ideal characters and very ideal life. What should a king do? What should a husband do? What should a brother do? Everyone is like perfect example of like a good brother, good wife. But Mahabharata is, like Rohan said, flawed people.
It's an exercise in tremendous amounts of real politics and family, this thing. Like,
and, absolutely. You know, not just the main characters, like the story of Karna and Yudhishthir and Duryodhan is beautiful.
Yeah.
The secondary cast, like Shikhandi and Ghatotkach, and all of them have their own beautiful story.
And that's what, so many sub-stories so beautifully nestled within it that it's kind of amazing. Since you guys have given two very amazing recommendations, I'm going to quickly throw mine on top of the pile and move on. The book I will always recommend to anybody is The Green Mile by Stephen King.
I was just going
to say, doesn't matter.
King book coming up.
Doesn't matter whether you're a Stephen King fan or not. Doesn't matter whether you're a reading fan or not. Doesn't matter whether you're an emotional person or not. I guarantee you by the end of that book, if you don't have big, fat, salty tears coming down your face, just go check where you are on the psychopath, sociopath scale. Like, it's just, that's just it. Oh, by the way, friends. Aaj se humare paas super chat hai. आज हमारे पास सुपर चैट है और आदित्य वर्मा ने बोला है, आई स्टार्टेड रीडिंग द सॉन्ग्स ऑफ अकिलीज, डू यू हैव सजेशंस अबाउट ग्रीक माइथोलॉजी बुक्स? पीएस, हेडीज इज एन अमेजिंग गेम अबाउट, आशीष, वेयर फर्मली इन योर व्हील हाउस हियर, कम ऑन.
सो दैट्स गुड. सो I really enjoy this because I went at it from the YA angle, which is where I started reading the Rick Riordan series.
You entered from the Percy Jackson place. I know this. You're a huge Percy Jackson fan.
Outstanding, because it really, especially if you're like the Harry Potter generation, it's really fun and it's way less serious than Harry Potter. So it's just like very American sort of humor. And it's great because you get to learn so much. That's the only reason I know Greek mythology is because I've charted the entire Percy Jackson series. There's Greek, then it segues into Roman because the Greek and Roman civilization was sort of one after the other, and they have lots in common, the mythology. And it's basically, the plot is that the Greek gods are still alive and present in the modern world. It's just that they've adapted, and the lead character that you're following, Percy Jackson, finds out he's a demigod. He's a son of a Greek god. So when they're alive, it means that Mount Olympus in Greece, for example, is situated in like a skyscraper in New York, Empire State or something. So if you go to the top floor, there's a magic portal and all that. And like, for example, Ares, the god of war, is shown as like a big, bad, leather-clad biker dude. Like, that's the interpretation. So they've given them these modern interpretations. And a lot of the stories from the classic myths, whether it's the story of Perseus and Medusa and all these characters.
Are they accurate to them, though, in the sense that, like, are they, more or less faithful recreations of those stories?
So the storyline is perfect. It mostly follows all those journeys. The adaptations, for example, Daedalus, the guy who who's the sun guy?
The sun guy.
Close to the sun, Icarus.
Icarus. Icarus flew way too close to the sun.
And uske saath kaun tha? Daedalus, I'm forgetting, but Daedalus was an inventor. So now in this, he has a laptop and he's like a tech with... Like, see, they've done all that cool stuff. And again, the storyline is great. And it's a fun series. I would definitely recommend that. And then I think I've started reading Mythos, which is almost over, which I like, which Rohan, you've read.
Yes.
I've been recommended Circe by Madeline Miller, which
I've heard. It's supposed to be very good.
Has recommended. That's also a great, great retelling. And I think it sort of has a more balanced perspective, because I think it's shown from her, like the woman's side, which is, they get maligned a lot in the main sort of mythology. So yeah, there's all of these options depending on what kind of tone you're looking at.
Can I tell you something very sad? Everything I know about Greek mythology is horse shit, because everything I know about Greek mythology, aside from the little Wikipedia reading I've done, comes from the first three God of War games.
Correct.
Everything. Correct. And the way the God of War games work is basically every god, if he is introduced, is just a matter of time until, how do we discover this person is an asshole?
Yeah, but, right, basically. But the Greeks were.
So I was like, was it really this? Because I know, right? I know that Zeus was problematic at best, etc. All of that. A little bit of a horny fellow, my understanding. And all of that. And I started looking it up and I'm like, pretty bad. But God of War really just takes it to, like, it turns it into like this, like, revenge fantasy, like, where every god is just killed. So as far as I know, my understanding of Greek mythology is there were a bunch of gods. They lived on Mount Olympus. One day, a man called Kratos got very pissed off and murdered all of them. All of them. Every single one. And when he was done with that, eventually he went HD and moved on to the Norse pantheon.
I started with God of War 4. That's my first God of War. And that's how I'm learning Norse mythology. And after watching Thor and all of that in the Avengers... There's some nice people, Odin and more or less, right?
Yeah, no, here to there.
Motherfucker, Thor's an asshole. Last four chapters of the main story.
Nobody gets redeemed or anything in God of War. That doesn't happen. More super chats. Anchal Jitendra Chadda, thank you. You're saying for your chat, you're saying you're my hero. Oh, that's so sweet. I'm happy that now you're a little active on your YouTube channel. I like to say, I like how you're a little active. Everybody accepts that I'm a little active. Also, I read a very good book called Invisible Women. It is fantastic. Anjali, if you could also let us know in the chat who Invisible Women is by, that would be excellent. Thank you so much. Riddhisha said, hi, recommend a few documentaries one must watch. Riddhi, this is a book recommendation thing. Thank you for your super chat, but I'll give it to you anyway. Watch Icarus, watch Waltz with Bashir, watch Exit Through the Gift Shop, and watch, give a documentary.
Fire in Babylon.
Also, if you're doing sports, then just Aakman Karke, please watch F1 Drive to Survive.
Yes.
On Netflix.
Also, Senna. Please watch Senna.
I've not seen Senna.
Please watch Senna.
And for a very easy World War viewing, World War II in color is outstanding on Netflix. Absolutely.
This thing... Samanvay Kumar has said that man, machine, and everything in between is one of the best observational bits out there. We've already answered Aditya Verma. We've already answered Anchal. Aman Singh has said, have you ever read A Little Life by Hanya Yanagihira? I'm sorry if I'm getting any of these pronunciations wrong. I apologize. Have we done any of... No? Yes? No.
I've not read this book. KV?
No.
No, I have not, unfortunately. Alas, it has not been read. Okay, moving on. Next question. We're going to keep going. I really need to get mods to help with this. Also, guys, please like, subscribe, all these things. I'm learning. I've just forgotten to say all these things.
You just forgot. Also, we've never sat there live going. You know, saying at the
end
of the
stage. Yeah, always record it. And the way it worked in other scenes was always recorded 4 days later, because someone would come and say, guys, wapis shoot pe subscribe link nahi shoot.
And be like, hey, guys, the red OnePlus charger and subscribe to AIB.
Right. Yeah. Have you met any famous authors? Have you met any famous authors? Says Rohan Patil. Hey, you met Mark Tully, no? Shax?
I was just thinking that.
You met Mark Tully, no?
Yes, you were drinking in Sri Lanka.
Yes.
In Gaul. And I mean, Rohan and I and a bunch of other friends were on vacation. And we saw him and he was a little by distance away. And we were very drunk. So we ended up took a photo. And I'm very proud of the caption.
Yeah. Ashish came back beaming. Like guys, guess what?
Because I had a great caption for my photo with Mark Tully, which was, Tully, main hu, Mark kidhar hai?
Nice. Like,
oh,
yeah,
beautiful.
Mere
Instagram pe hai ye photo.
Ali OP in chat, please. Ali OP in chat, please.
Hey, who have we met, though? Who have we met? I'm sure we met, like, somebody. Who is Mila, kya?
We met Saurabh Pant.
Met Saurabh Pant for sure. Kautuk Srivastav, written book. Which other authors, yeah?
Sidhin Vadukat, of course.
Of course.
Met, like, talking about Saurabh Pant, I've met a few authors on Zoom call during
hey,
lockdown.
I've met
Vikram Chandra.
Yes, Vikram Chandra. I've met Vikram Chandra. I interviewed him before Sacred Games. It was like one full, like, this thing moment for me.
KV met Ramchandra Guha.
I met Veer Sanghvi, Ramchandra Guha, Vikram Chandra, William Dalrymple. And, like, completely fanboyed all four of them.
That is amazing. Okay, again, very quickly going to do some super chats. Feral Mind wants to know, are Terry Pratchett, Douglas Adams and Neil Gaiman in your wheelhouse? Definitely all three in my wheelhouse. Pratchett is the one I've read the least. Don't at me in the chat. I know that's one deficient area. But Douglas Adams, Neil Gaiman. My other answer for what book would you recommend whenever would be Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
So I want to say that's one.
Yeah. So those. What about you guys? Pratchett, Gaiman, Adams. Just such three unique voices, right?
Yes. Not much of Pratchett and Gaiman, but definitely huge, huge fan of Douglas Adams. Like, big fan
the
of
OG.
The OG.
The OG.
Oh my God. I still have that 5-book set with, like, the restaurant at the end of the galaxy.
Yeah, yeah, of course. Of course. No, of course. And have you read Salmon of Doubt, the unfinished one?
Like, no. I'm yet
it's to got a lot of, it's unfinished and it's got a bunch of other work and it's really fun. If not, Sukanya says she doesn't really have a question. I just wanted to congratulate you for Wake and Baking. Ash, thank you.
Hey, yeah, congratulations.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. That was a very pleasant and unexpected surprise, and I am very happy by this. Suraj wants to know, hey guys, I'm loving, thank you for your chat, Suraj. Suraj wants to know, I wanted to get some book recommendations by LGBTQ authors in India. Do you guys have any good reads, pun intended? Ah, I see what you did there, by these authors. As a cishet man, I must admit that my experience in these is limited. My consumption of work that of authors that I know are openly LGBTQ is, I have to say, limited. I would be the wrong person to recommend one
Vivek,
because
Vivek Tejuja has a book, which I would.
Vivek Tejuja has a book. Yeah, Vivek Tejuja. Vivek Tejuja, actually, in general, if you go on Instagram, is a great person to recommend books.
Dude, he's one like crazy book. I mean, like, he knows all the books.
He does. Yeah, that actually is a very apt. He knows all the books.
All the books.
Like, Vivek Tejuja knows all the books. That is absolutely 100% accurate. That is true for sure. Okay, so that is our super chats. Now, moving on. Wait, here we go. Given a choice to live, okay, so Sharia has said, given a choice to live in any fandom, which one would you choose and why? I'm going to modify that a bit too. If there was one fantasy world that you could live in.
Fantasy world.
Which one? Because fandoms inevitably always end up either becoming in some way toxic or hectic. So if you could live in a fantasy, so to speak, which one would that be? And I would not live in Westeros because, like, just if you're not like royalty, you just die. Like,
too
it's a shit place to live in. It's a one-star review, 100%. Like, just absolute one-star review nonsense. Would not do. Where would you?
There's so many options.
And it has to be a fantasy world, right?
I mean, any fictional world. It doesn't necessarily have to be fantasy. Any fictional world. You could jump into any fictional book and read in that, live in that world. I'm going to again...
2020 dystopia is quite cool. Guys,
have tried. 2020 dystopia is quite cool. It's true. Happy to live here only.
Yeah.
Happy to live here only. KV?
I first thought LOTR, but then you said the probability of dying is very... Saruman can kill you anytime. I would actually go with the Hitchhiker's universe.
Because it's random and beautiful.
Random
and anything can happen.
Space shuttle, you keep doing
but you random. Wouldn't want to be living on Earth because, you know, the Vogons are destroying it to build that gigantic interstate highway that they need to build. So I would recommend moving if I were you.
With those guys. Like, just
that would be fun.
Exactly.
Kajal wants to know, thank you, Kajal, for your chat. Any book which actually affected your life decision? Mine was As a Man Thinketh. And big congratulations for Wake and Bake. Thank you. But yeah, what book like completely sort of changed your... Or has there been a book that impacted you in a way where it actually changed or made you want to sort of live like different? Like one book that had a profound impact on me was Mouse by Art Spiegelman. Because it just sort of recontextualized. You always knew, right? Like reading history, etc., whatever, how horrific it was. But it sort of made that tale so personal, so deeply personal and so beautifully etched that it really, I think, kind of changed in terms of empathy.
I think Resnick Halliday, 11th and 12th physics, it made me realize that mujhse na ho payega.
Resnick Halliday, actually, you know what? That answer is the same for me. That's exactly how I decided. I can't do IIT. I opened Resnick Halliday, 10 pages in, I was like, nope.
So that pretentious type, like this Resnick Halliday, this
correct.
Boyd,
Irodov or Loni pad raha hai, please chat me batao so that I can give you a hug because oh my god, I Irodov.
Okay, very quickly going to go through some super chats because they're coming in. Viresh says, big fan of all three. One recommendation, please make a list of all the books you recommend or talk about and pin the chat or add it to the description, please. Also, never knew you guys were F1 fans. Stick around, you'll learn fun things about us. We will, of course, at the end of the stream at some point, I will be diligent enough to take rewatch it and make a list of everything. I promise, I will do my best. Vajdan says, just hopped on recently, so I'm not sure if you've been asked this. Thoughts on Arundhati Roy's fiction. Mm-hmm. What do you guys think? I think her use of language is spectacular. Yeah. And I think The God of Small Things was a good book. Yeah. And that's pretty much it for me, in a sense. That's about all the opinion that I have.
Yeah. I would quickly say answer the last question, Ron. Sure. Because you said the book that sort of impacted you the most is for me, that would be Midnight's Children. And I'll tell you why. Because like growing up, since I used to read a lot, I always thought that, you know, I had a very like very standard Indian schoolboy journey of reading books. When you start reading with like any Blighted, then you go to Sidney Sheldon, then Dan Brown, like Godfather. And then one fine day, and you keep hearing about Midnight's Children, Salman Rushdie, but you haven't really read it. One fine day in Delhi, and this is at Malviya Nagar, one roadside stall, I was waiting for a friend with pre-smartphone, so you didn't have anything to do. So I just picked Midnight's Children. I thought, let's finally read it. I read the first page and it blew my mind. I had never read a writing.
It is a beautiful book.
I was like, how is this so heavy? Like, how is one sentence encapsulating so many things? How is he like saying so much in just
it's dense and it's beautiful.
Every sentence is beautiful, and that changed my mind because that set the benchmark for me in terms of writing a lot, like way up. Because till then I was like, hey, koi bhi book likh sakta hai, main ek din book likhunga. That sort of delayed my author plan by I don't know decades. Till then I was like, hey, even I can write a 5-point someone, I'm an engineer.
you can write a 5-point someone. It's not
difficult. You can. You absolutely can. nothing will stop you from doing that.
You know, as an artist, you know, if you really see a great piece of art, you're like, oh man, I'm miles away from this. You know, when you read
one of those books where you're like, or you watch one of those shows where you're like, you know, technically maybe writer who? Like technically, I do the same thing this guy does. Technically. But we may as well be two different species.
You've also played basketball. Kabhi, aisa half.
But I'm not Jordan.
It makes you think. It makes you like work harder, maybe.
Absolutely.
And on the Arundhati Roy thing, beautiful writing.
Absolutely.
It honestly gets boring sometimes, but the way, like the writing is beautiful. Like God of Small Things, beautiful book. Like debatable, but beautiful. Like I love her writing. Like we could always talk about her, like otherwise political opinions, etc.
As a writer, specifically his thoughts on Arundhati Roy's fiction. And that, Suraj has one more question. What are your thoughts on David Sedaris? I just finished reading Calypso and was howling with laughter. I have not read Calypso. What other Sedaris books do you guys love?
I have not read David Sedaris. I've heard so much about him as a humorist.
Same. I was a Dave Barry boy.
So if you mention Okay, life changing in that sense? Yeah.
Like, oh, Dave Barry changed all our lives.
Yeah,
I think we
all
read.
All our lives.
It was the first time I read a piece of nonfiction writing when people write nonfiction like, just to make you laugh.
Just to make
like
you
it's
laugh.
Not like, always news possible. And this and that. People, it's a
yeah.
thing.
You know what? I didn't really read much nonfiction before that, and then I read it. So all the structure, all the joke writing, everything I know is literally from reading his books. And
yeah.
I think most people, if we started writing around the same time, like in the early 2000s, I think mid 2000s, hum log, like you'll notice that influence early on. And like we just learned it by like reading that.
Oh, 100%. 100%.
Matlab wo to baap writer.
Azima wants to know, what is your favorite biographical / autobiographical book? Mine is Alan Turing, The Enigma. Azima, thank you for your chat.
Wow. What a great question.
That is a tremendously good question. That is a tremendously good question. Biographical / autobiographical book.
Do you read a lot of biographical, autobiographical stuff?
Last few years, I have.
I have in the last few years. I mean, there's all your serious ones, right? Like, I have an answer. It's done. It's over. Azima, there is only one answer to this question. It is called The Life and Times of the Thunderbolt Kid. It's written by Bill Bryson, and he's the greatest writer that ever lived. And that is my answer.
Okay, I'm going with a safe, very Mahabharata kind of an answer on this as well. I would recommend My Experiments with Truth by Mahatma Gandhi. I really think, really, and I'm not being pretentious, really think every Indian should learn more about Mahatma Gandhi, especially in today's times. And I can talk about him for hours, but I just want to recommend My Experiments with Truth by Mahatma Gandhi.
My Experiments with Truth, na wo car chase sequence ka baat hai.
It's after the dragon slaying. Abhyuday, thank you for your super chat. Any book series like The Witcher in the fantasy genre? Specifically like The Witcher? I'm not sure. So wait, when you say specifically like The Witcher, you mean like what? It involves like a dude with a sword on a mission.
It's way fantasy monsters and
fantasy.
All that stuff, right?
Song of Ice and Fire.
What's the next like? Yeah, because what's the last like questy fantasy book that I sort of read? It's been a while since I read one, so I'm going to defer to our panel of experts here.
I barely read fantasy, to be honest. Like,
I think people in chat will know better.
I guess I should refund your money.
No, it's a very well-read audience in the chat, so I think they would know.
Pranjalya Tiwari has said, loved Irodov, Irodov OP, blocked.
Kahan se aa jate hain ye log? Main bata do, kahan se aate hain ye log? IIT se aate hain.
Exactly.
Jahan pe hum log
nahi hai. Exactly. Also, in general, people who are on this stream and people who are watching, just go through the chat whenever you can, because holy crap, this chat is like a goldmine of book recommendations right now from everybody.
Yeah.
There's amazing things here. Aman Singh, small introduction to the Dune universe. Smallest introduction you need is that fear is the mind killer. But the important thing about the Dune... Okay, so Dune is a fantasy series.
Ooh.
Does that also technically kind of answer the question about the Witcher type series? Because it is a very different fantasy series. Dune is unique. Dune was written like almost 70 years ago now. It is set on a desert planet, which is sort of like the Westerosi equivalent of Tatooine, where just imagine danger lurking at every corner. It's Game of Thrones, but on Tatooine. And it's Game of Thrones decades and decades before there was Game of Thrones. It has some pretty deeply profound philosophy in there. What is great about it is that unlike a lot of fantasy books, this one is also very internal. It delves a lot into your protagonist's mind and state of mind, and it's actually a deeply philosophical treatise. Then as the story goes forward, in fact, book two becomes even more internal. And it that way bucks a lot of fantasy conventions. I'm very curious to see what Denis Villeneuve's movie is going to be like, because, man, I still personally believe that there are parts of that book that are unfilmable, but what do I know? But I would definitely recommend that everybody reads it before the movie comes out, because it's too good. Too good.
Too good.
Too good. Like, it's also going to be extremely interesting, because I don't, this is something that people dance around a lot, but it's got heavily Middle Eastern influences. And the central sort of war cry of what you would call the good guys, essentially the battle, it is essentially the sort of concept of jihad. Mm-hmm. Now, That's where it, and now obviously you're in 2020, and I'm genuinely wondering if this major Hollywood studio looked at that and been like, huh, I wonder what we're going to do with that. And it's, I'm just very interesting to see if that's actually something that they can sort of work in or sort of hold true to the book, I think.
I have full faith in the Hollywood machinery to find a way around it.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. So, Omar Khurshid, what is your favorite fantasy series? Mine is Stephen Erickson's Malazan, Book of the Fallen. My favorite fantasy series is Stephen King's Dark Tower series, hands down. If I had to follow it up, I would follow it up with a series that I recently read a couple of years ago, which is N.K. Jemisin's Broken Earth Trilogy.
Those are my, you recommended to me that day,
which is what I 100% recommended. Beautiful, beautiful books. Those Stephen Erickson's Book of the Fallen, I've heard, is also quite astonishing. Have to get on that for sure. What is your favorite fantasy series, friends?
I would say Lord of the Rings.
Even with all the digression? Like, let's have this out. Like, even with all the... Let me interrupt to just tell you the random tales of Tom Bombadil. This could have been... This is like that meme, that thick book, thin book. Like, Lord of the Rings. Lord of the Rings, if, like, he just stayed the course.
Yeah, I mean, you're right. But yeah, even with the digression, I would
say... Okay, fair.
Maybe it's just nostalgia or the movies were too good.
The movies were too good. I still remember it being one of the first sort of communal fanboy experiences you could have with friends.
I've lost count of number of times I've sent Riders of Rohan to Rohan.
Like, yeah, yeah, literally, like every time he watches the movie, I'll get one Riders of Rohan theme.
Background music.
Like, I'll be sitting going about my day, suddenly message from KV, I'll be like, oh, quiz hoga shayad. And then no, it's just Riders of Rohan scene from Lord of the Rings. Because he's been watching it.
I've not Riders of Rohan Joshi just sounds funny, whatever
it is. It does. Or like my Tinder bio.
Super chat.
Omar, thank you for your super chat. Caroline Elizabeth, super chat. Congratulations on Wake and Bake. What are your top three desert island books?
Robinson Crusoe, Swiss Family Robinson, and The Beach.
You know what? As good an answer as any.
Technically.
Also. As good an answer as any. All three desert island books, AD. My favorite desert island book is The Martian.
Also correct.
What do you guys think? Psychiatric, which is PSICKTRICK. Thank you for your super chat. What do you guys think about the true crime genre?
Yeah, it's, I mean, it's not something I've really gotten into either as books or even as these documentaries and all these shows on Netflix. I don't know. It's just something that I haven't gotten into.
I enjoy it, but I also, on some level, am very aware of the fact that this is entertainment sometimes and not necessarily, like even Serial, right? Great and all of that. But you're still essentially hearing one person's narrative reconstruction of an old case. And I feel like that's something that can get lost sometimes in true crime documentary. And people are like, you should reopen the case on the basis of this, and you should do this, and you should do that, and you should do that. And sometimes, yes, great. But sometimes they're just a bit like, should you know? On the basis of what one podcast said or what one this thing said. So I don't know. I feel like true crime, there are two sides to it. I feel like it works way better for the retrospective. Like, I love watching the Bundy tapes, right? Ted Bundy's dead. Yeah. It's too late. It's too late for him to do anything. I mean, huge fan.
Yeah.
I love the fictionalized versions of those. So, like, the People versus OJ, great.
Oh, yeah, superb.
A straight up OJ documentary, I'd be less likely to watch.
Yeah.
That is fair.
Similar with Ted Bundy, although I am fascinated by serial killers in general. So there's that. So I should
probably. I just want to tell people that views expressed on this stream belong to the people who have said
Dexter
that.
Dexter, by the way, Dexter's coming back.
After that, like, what to undo that horrific ending?
I don't know what they'll do. KV, you were saying something, sorry.
KV.
Yeah, I'm saying I haven't read much, just like Ashish said. I've watched like true crime documentaries like Ted Bundy and everything. Never really got into reading about true crime. I don't know if...
Yeah, I haven't done that much true crime reading. Actually, you know what? I used to when I was a kid. And
dude,
is...
there were these books, I remember.
Yeah. World Famous.
Yes.
Or
yes.
World's Greatest or something it was
Mysteries.
Called.
Ah,
World's
that's
Greatest.
That's the only one I remember.
And you used to get them. And the thing is, you used to get them at your school book stores.
School library.
You used to... No, school library and even the school book store that you went at the start of the year to buy your textbooks from. These guys would fully be there. And 13-year-old me was fully drawn in by the lurid cover of this one particular book called World's Greatest Serial Killers.
Yeah.
And the book legit had like a decapitated like head on it, etc., all of that. I still remember I once took it into the bathroom to read it, and I left it in there, and I came out, and my dad went to the bathroom after me. He came out with this full, only book ever in my entire life, where he's going to be like, what the fuck is this? It'll rot your brain. What nonsense? You're 13 years old. You can't be reading about some guy that killed 8 of his wives and put them in acid. What's wrong with you? And I never saw that book again. But the damage was done by then.
That's the plot for Rohan Raghav. You
know? That is Rohan Raghav 3.0.
Rohan Raghav.
Srijit Gopalakrishnan wants to know, oh, this is a good question, actually. Do you do audiobooks? Srijit, thank you for your chat. Do you do audiobooks? I got introduced to them with The Martian. Loved it. Any recommendations for audiobooks and your thoughts on the experience? I have so far not really tried audiobook.
Yeah, I'll tell you. This became a thing like a year or like a couple of years back, right? When Audible and all came. I personally can't do fiction on like audio.
Sure.
So I tried and I was like, no, this is not working.
Okay.
So I then went to nonfiction and then tried it. Still didn't work because I was like, I'm missing things and I have to pause and like go back. So now I do completely proper nonfiction in the sense that courses, like there are like, this is what Biswa recommended to me and really worked for me. On Audible, there's something called Great Courses or Great Learning, Great Courses, something like that, which just has like 8-10 chapters of just like on economics, on history.
Oh,
on
nice.
Mythology or like stuff like that.
Is it courses in the sense it's like a textbook thing? Like, is it?
Yeah,
like,
so it's what? Like these are basically lectures.
Okay.
In like audio format. So it's much. So I'm trying to start to listen to that, and I also started like Ikigai and all, which is like very basic, like someone just telling you things. And if it works, then I might just try a non-fiction, like something in the Sapien zone. And if that works, then maybe, I don't know, fiction someday. But I can't imagine listening to fiction.
Yeah, I don't know. I can't. I don't know.
I think, I don't know, it's a generation age thing. But yeah, I feel like I'm firmly in the, I have to read it and then imagine for myself. Like,
yeah.
thing. Vaishali wants to know. Sorry, go for it. Shax, you were saying something.
No, I'm just saying that we're used to when you read, everything is silent. Right. And it's so the idea of calling it reading and then something going on in your ears is it strikes me as
No. That's the problem. Not at all. Vaishali Tucker, any history related book recommendations, not bestsellers or popular ones? I've already read quite a few of them. Also, Chambaka Bookstore has curated list of books by Indian LGBTQ authors. Thank you, Vaishali. If you could also tell us where that bookstore is, what city, that would be very, very helpful. Thank you. But history recommendations, friends?
Heavy.
Man, there are just so many history books to recommend. I don't know.
I'm just going to go stretch my legs, KV. You got this for the next 10 minutes.
Yeah, I think.
Let's do it quickly and just recommend one book or something.
Sure.
There's a book called India, A History by John Key, which I highly recommend if someone wants to read Indian history. India, A History by John Key. Reason I recommend it is because it just is a summary of our country since like some BC Vedic era till today. Like it covers till emergency, I think. So it's a wonderful, like, because with history, you read, you get an overall perspective and then you sort of try and get into specifics, right?
Right.
Like you read the over, then you're like, okay, Mughal era interests me. And then you read like Mughal.
You basically need these short, quick gateway drug books, right? That get you deeper into the subject. Like, for example, I found that Emperors of the Peacock Throne by Abraham Erali is a great, like, sort of gateway drug into just understanding the Mughal era, for example, right? It's like just a chapter on each person and you get the groundwork and then you can choose to go deeper.
And you can choose. That's why the one book I recommend would be India History by John Key.
Mm-hmm. Okay, fantastic. So, India History by John Key. Ankit Israni wants to know, what are your thoughts on Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl? This is a book that I see come up a lot. I have personally not yet read it. Shame, but I see it come up a lot. It comes up a lot on Reddit. It comes up a lot in forums. It comes up a lot everywhere.
No, I haven't read it.
Ashish?
Not read.
Thank you for joining Stream of Books by three people who not read books.
You know, I feel like maybe I should set some expectations, all these books seems like a lot of people are so well read. Like with me, it's always been, ever since I was a child, it's always been, I want to be entertained by a book. very rarely will and I sit through something fair. That is boring, even if it's important, and so on and so forth. So, like, my choices then are a little more. I mean, that's why I'm unlikely to have read this book by Viktor Frankl. It's not to say I won't read that genre. It's just it's not my immediate like go to. Yeah.
That's fair. And in 2020, if your only aim is to be entertained, Shaq, I will not judge you. Enough, real. Enough.
Yeah, I mean, wo to alag struggle. Just sitting down on the Kindle at the end of the day, you have to force yourself to get on
the
floor.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. For our life, I'm Neil. I want to host you in Amsterdam. And I want an e-commerce agency. I want to help pimp all three of your brands. Where can I get in touch? I guess on each other's or each people's respective Instagram accounts, we have business inquiry. Yes. Banners and you can hit that. But thank you for your chat, For Our Life, aka Neil. Rohit wants to know, Rohit Devadiga wants to know, a big fan of you guys, what books would you suggest? Well, it's a good one. What books would you suggest to convert a non-reader into a reader? Congrats on making big. KV, love your podcast with Biswa. I think that everybody does. Books to convert non-readers.
This is what I said in one of the some live.
I will send it to you on Zoom.
Ashish has a joke that he doesn't want to make on this.
I have
thing.
Jail answer.
Ashish, go for it.
No, aap baat karo.
No. He's saying not going to.
Non-reader into reader. I think one basic thing should be like very basic question. What is it that interests you in life?
Nice.
What is it that interests you? And... Sorry. That's it. Like if you're into, like you've never read a book, but you love Manchester United, for example, then you pick a book about, say, Ryan Giggs or Alex Ferguson or something.
Sure.
Then you start reading it. Obviously, you love it because you're already in love with that universe. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Once you finish the book, the accomplishment of finishing your first book is like you can't match it.
That's a great recommendation, actually. Find a word you already love as a non-reader. And then sort of get into reading that thing. Like,
why did an entire generation love 5.someone so much? Is also because that was the world everyone
was. Yeah, absolutely. 100%. Oh, 5.someone was relatability maximum for this country, I think. Like,
maximum
relatability. You can say whatever you want about Chetan Bhagat and whatever, but relatability, bhai ne must crack kiya.
Yeah, he did the same thing that everyone does on YouTube now.
Yeah.
One-edit call sector, again, very targeted.
I think
honest engineering college.
But I think, KV, that's a great approach if somebody is a non-reader. Be like, what stuff do you like? Usme. Just an extension of that, I think most people would be fine with stuff that moves fast. It's like reactionary, especially for a complete non-reader. So that genre is, I think, the easiest to get into.
Yeah, 100%. Recommend your favorite book to someone. Doesn't make sense. Like, if
I feel like another genre that's very easy to get into, no matter what you're into, is inherently like the murder mystery genre or like the detective genre, because inherently the plot pulls you in, right? There's such a big mystery at the heart of it that every chapter usually ends with some form of, but then. So mystery and detective books are also great. Great way to get over a reading slump.
Yeah. Agatha Christie, Agatha Christie would be a great.
Agatha Christie, Sherlock Holmes, like all of them would be amazing.
Dude, on apna perception, it's so skewed because I don't know if it's still the case, but like in general, when you're kids, if you were seen reading a book as a kid, right? Like slightly thickish book also, 300, 400 pages, whatever. People would assume you were smart. Little did they know. And you were reading Sidney Sheldon, which fits this exact genre of mystery, murder and crime and shit is happening, and it's exciting. It's
the
like a
pulpiest
movie.
Pulp.
The pulpiest, or even like slightly better than the espionage thrillers and all of that. It's you learn more history with that, but you're essentially reading very exciting books.
Yes,
you're not sitting there with Siddhartha, you know, or Nietzsche or whatever. So it's a great hack to appear smart, guys.
Ulysses. Good to see, thank you for your chat. Hey OGs, please share some tips on how to fall in love with books for people like me who have no patience only. I think KV answered that pretty well right now. Start with a world you already love, even if you have no patience for books, and go from there. By the way, A Feast of Vultures by Josie Joseph is a great book. I agree, good to see, I would 100% recommend A Feast of Vultures by Josie Joseph for everybody. It is by and large about Jet Airways. But it is also overall just a tremendous story about how capitalism and competition truly works in this amazo.
Yeah.
Basically. Yeah. So, yeah. That's next. That's questions. Wait, let's get more questions. What are your thoughts on Palace of Illusions by Chitra Banerjee, Divakarun?
Yeah, I did refer to it when I was talking about Mahabharata. Wonderful, yeah. Wonderful book. It's basically just Mahabharata from the eyes of Draupadi.
Yes, and that is what it is.
Beautifully done. Like one of the best interpretations of Mahabharata I've ever read. And with an epic like that, you just change the perspective. It's like a great scene with different camera. And it's really well done. I mean,
it is.
I love Palace of Illusions.
It is a very, very fantastic book. And you have said everything that I wanted to say about it. It's beautiful and absolutely something that everybody should read. Okay, let's find some more questions. Okay, that's one question done. We're halfway there, guys. Halfway there.
Oh, awesome.
Uzair Khan wants to know, what's a good guide to start Neil Gaiman? What's a good guide to start Neil Gaiman? I would say start with American Gods or Neverwhere. And if you're up for it and if you like comic books, start with Sandman. Start with Neil Gaiman's entire and complete Sandman. It's the best. It's the absolute best. Truly.
Only read American Gods. Not read anything else.
Okay. Fair.
Sorry, I'm also just seeing the chat.
Yeah, no, please go for it. Please find questions. Be great. How do I get rid of this stupid thing at the bottom?
Please don't talk about KV like that.
Oh, wow. Oh,
my team, you're at the bottom.
Yeah, Shax. Exactly. My team, you're at the bottom, Shax. What the hell?
Foiled by Zoom.
Aditya Maladi, any books for someone who is suicidal? Read A Man Called Ove. It will bring hope back into your life. Read happy books if you're feeling
that way. Man Called Ove, and man, there was this other book on Shiny Happy Book Club which they talked about. Matt Haig ki hai. I've not read it, but it came highly recommended. Matt Haig, Reason to Live or something like that it's called.
Any feel-good book, like just even Alchemist would help, I guess.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Man Called Ove, rather. Great book.
Yeah, it is. It is tremendously good. That is another question done.
Matt Haig, Reasons to Stay Alive. I've not read it, but it came
back. That is the one. That is the one. Classics that were plain boring. Oh, Vishnu Vardhanan. Classics that were plain boring. I recently read Three Men in a Boat, but did not enjoy it much. Give your answers, friends, and I will
Three
give
Men
mine.
In a Boat. Wow, what a...
I don't even remember this book.
Yeah, I remember that quote is used at so many places that I love work. I can stare at it for hours. That's actually from Three Men in a Boat. And To Say Nothing of the Dog, right? That's the full name of the book, right? Three Men in a Boat.
And To Say Nothing of the Dog.
Classics which are boring, most of them.
Because they are time and place, and we were so Eurocentric that anything like a guy wrote in the 17th, 18th, whatever, 18th, 19th century was like, oh, you have to read this. And I'm like,
yeah, boring. Like a book that I absolutely could not read, and I apologize, but I just could not. Dracula. Like, I know it's supposed to be this all-time classic love story, etc., all of that. Uh-huh. But the book Dracula by Bram Stoker is the most boring version of Dracula that exists, unfortunately. Like, if there's one character that I'm glad got a gritty reboot, it is Count Dracula via other people. And I don't care if this is sacrilege, but mere se nahi hota.
Oh, dude, even the Ramsey reboot was probably better.
Of course.
More exciting.
Dude, Dracula is this fucking big, all right? When I read it as a kid, I thought I was going to finally read a version of all these amazing, superbly gross toys that I've read. And it's like, you know how if you were ever watching a movie for a sex scene, like if somebody told you it had lots of sex scenes in it, then you found out that the movie had all of 4 seconds of sex in it. Dracula is like that, but with action. Somebody told you Dracula is going to be this and that and scary, and there's like maybe 7 scary pages in like this 600-page book. And it is very disappointing.
Maine na bachpan mein, there used to be these abridged versions of these classics. So those you read as a kid.
Little square pocketbook size ones. Yeah, with the illustrations.
Bacha, right?
Of course.
Yeah, you were like 7 or 8, so you raced through those. Yeah. So
abridged illustrated classics.
Yeah,
they were called.
So then I didn't get to like the big Tom Sawyer because I had read Tom Sawyer.
Ha ha.
Same.
Yeah.
So, Yeah, but what are these? You know what? It's not like, okay, it's a classic now. I suppose Fountainhead, dude. I got so damn bored.
Dude, I really fuck that.
I left
book.
It at 30%, 40%.
Ekdam nonsense, 40-30 nonsense.
Not even the politics of it, like, but
no, no,
like,
just
bored ho gaya.
Same. Sorry, can't get behind
read
that.
The book. Whole book, but then yeah, like Rohan said, I have a problem with the. What is it trying to say?
It's just you know what? Okay, I understand America now.
Yeah.
I understand America now, and that's not necessarily a good thing. That. It's exactly that. Like, worst architect you can have, right?
Worst architect ever.
Plans kab aayega, sir? You know.
And I remember why I also left. This was the reason. Because this guy was like, passion follow karna. I was like, I get the point. But I was in engineering and I was like, "Basically, nahi ho raha passion follow. Fuck this.
Ah, nahi ho raha passion follow. I'm going
to need a reminder.
Haan, again, yeah,
passion's good. Nice. Good for you.
Hold on. One sec. Let me see if exiting full screen will help get rid of that thing. Has it gotten rid of that thing? I don't know if it's gotten rid of that thing. I can't tell. I just have to, at some point, Google and figure out how to get rid of the bar at the bottom, I guess. 30 questions who have not given their name. Thank you for your super chat. Your question is, any economics, geopolitics book recommendations?
Okay.
Ooh.
Okay. Wow.
I think like the easiest ones to would be to do stuff like Freakonomics was one of.
Yeah. Always start with Freakonomics, because when you start with a pop version of any science, is always an easier way into it.
Yeah.
Than really like the hard science.
Also damn interesting Freakonomics.
Oh, it's great. Yeah. Oh, it's tremendous.
Wow.
Tremendously fun book.
Yeah. Like how data can be funny, or like how
and
how research can be just amazing. Like just research.
Yeah, absolutely. A geopolitics book, one really interesting one that I enjoyed. This was actually Tushar's recommendation, Shax. Is this book called Magnificent Delusions.
Delusions, right?
By Hussein Haqqani.
Yeah.
Which is about the relationship over sort of 70 years between America and Pakistan. Essentially, the sort of geopolitical clusterfucks that have occurred as a result of America being America, per huge.
As an add-on to it, I have not finished this book. Read about 25-30%. Ghost Wars. Same. CIA involvement in Afghanistan, Pakistan, and entire history of that. Fucking crazy shit, dude. The way they came in and the way they aligned with different factions and how they bribed it and how it was. It's crazy so far. So Ghost Wars by Steve something is also in that same space.
Also in that same space with the whole Afghanistan thing, The Great Game by Peter Hopkirk.
Yeah.
Very good book.
Yeah. Also like Shaq said earlier, like when you read some of these fun spy dramas, sometimes you learn a lot about geopolitics. So I would just randomly recommend Frederick Forsyth to everyone.
Frederick Forsyth?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Band karke.
Of course.
God. Yeah. No, Frederick Forsyth was an actual spy. In the war.
Yes.
So he knows his shit.
Learned just by reading his like really fun, intriguing, captivating books. It's great. It's intense. Like when we went to Ukraine, Rahul and I we were just talking about things. What can we do here? They were like, you can go to Chernobyl. Like, yeah, okay, we'll try. And then they said you can go to Odessa. Like,
Odessa.
Odessa. Oh my god.
And Biswa is like, "Main waise to aaya." But yeah, Odessa Files, great book. Odessa Files, great book. Dude, so again, I started reading Ludlum in school, Ludlum and then Fawcett.
Yeah.
And that's where this interest in like modern history, World War II history and all that shit comes from, just from there.
Yeah, Ludlum. Yeah,
great way to get into it.
Ek
aur book recommend karu?
Yes, please recommend karo.
Because you mentioned economics, I've just started reading this book called Narconomics. It's by the editor of Tom Wainwright, who's the editor of The Economist, I think.
Okay.
So it's just an economic understanding of the drug cartels in Mexico, Colombia, South America, essentially. Narcos, but seen from, like his contention is that they are run like businesses. They do the same thing that a McDonald's does or a Burger King does or Pepsi does to grow their brand, supply chain, all of that shit. So it's just that. And I've just started it. Narconomics. It seems very
good. Narconomics. That sounds good. Diksha Sharma, thank you for your super chat. What are your thoughts on Murakami? She wants to know. I've read Kafka on the Shore and it messed with my head. Also, I love classics. Are there any classic books that you love? So I'm going to count those as two questions, because they are two questions. Because those are Murakami, what are your thoughts? Personally, 50-50. think a little overrated, but that's my personal opinion. I know that I am not very strongly supported in that opinion. Theek hai, hai Kafka shore pe, matlab bahut acha hai sabke liye.
In this chat, you have my support. I don't know about KV, but yeah, I've read like half of Sputnik Sweetheart and I was like, haan, theek hai, matlab sundar hai in parts, but aise nahi ho raha.
But what is the point?
I'm very surprised all three of us are on the same page of
Murakami.
Because the only book I've read is Kafka on the Shore. And I found it like very difficult to comprehend at some parts. I was like, kya chal raha hai? You know what I mean? Like when you're reading something with the fish and all, I'm like, okay. I know you're trying shit, but like, okay. And then I started reading Norwegian Wood, could not left it. Then I thought, what I think about when I running both that I said I was like wo bhi nahi hua tha na, I'm like okay maybe wrong kya ho raha hai,
is Murakami or
am
Toby,
I guys? The problem
no is Murakami or Toby
is Murakami yeah Murakami is Toby just fuck that guy.
Magic realism mere se nahi hota वैसे भी
देखो मतलब कभी कभी होता है right like I mean I guess like what like Junot not Diaz counts as like magical realism does he? I don't know like, yeah, like does Rushdie something like Brief Wonders Life of Oscar Wilde count because then yeah. I mean I can handle some but I don't know I about Rushdie. The others
because maybe that magic realism is closer to my realism maybe that
correct maybe
but maybe and like Gabriel Garcia Marquez also is fine but Murakami I don't know I could never really. Maybe I need to go back once more to one of these Murakami and try and
maybe it's okay.
It's fine. It's fine. It's a big wide world. There's nothing. There's no loss. There's no this thing.
Force yourself.
Also, what's a classic that you love? To answer a second question. What is a classic that you love? Like for me, the unqualified, undeserved answer is one, anything by Jules Verne. And two, The Hound of the Baskervilles. I think that it was the first book I ever read as a child where I understood what mood setting could be. Like I remember reading that book. And I was sitting in hot ass Bombay in summer and I remember feeling like, oh ho, mere samajh mein aa raha hai, Scottish moor kya hota hai.
Yeah,
like, oh, you know, like I understand, yeah, yeah, yeah. I get it, thund and fog and this gosh. And that.
Oh, I love it when a book does that.
Yeah.
Classics mein Doyle hi aega, everything else, it just seems like...
Fair.
Not exciting.
My one classic that I keep going back to is Crime and Punishment by Dostoevsky.
Nice.
I don't know. There's something about Dostoevsky, especially Crime and Punishment. I don't know. The entire thing of that character. Again, I'm going back to character arc. Of his motivation in life and what happens to him later. The entire loop. All the characters. And again, like very similar to Rohan. When I was reading it, I was in Noida. I used to like work in TCS. So I used to travel in that bus every day. And I used to keep recreating that book in my mind in that setting. You know, we tend to do that as a reader, right? Like,
yeah.
If it becomes like this in fiction, then how will it look? I'm like, this book should be recreated and this is one of my like unfulfilled ambition. One day to adapt Crime and Punishment in Indian setting as a writer.
That'll be quite an undertaking.
Ooh, somebody has mentioned this because you talk about classics and I would agree that somebody said Fyodor is overrated. That's KV obviously disagrees. But uske niche kise Saptarishi Mukherjee ne kaha Catcher in the Rye and I'm like, nah, ye bahut boring book tha.
Bahut boring book tha. Bahut hi behad boring book tha. देखो बिल्कुल समझ में नहीं आया मैं बहुत पक गया वो बुक पढ़ के बहुत पक ऑल अग्रीड विथ यू 100% आकांक्षा देसाई थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर चैट आई लव यू गाइस व्हाट इज योर फेवरेट बाय मार्क ट्वेन लव द इनोसेंस अब्रॉड आल्सो रिकमेंडेशंस ऑन सोशल एंड जेंडर पैरिटी आई एम अगेन टेकिंग दोस टू सेपरेट क्वेश्चन बिकॉज दे आर टू सेपरेट मार्क ट्वेन आई एम द एडवेंचर्स ऑफ हकलबरी फिन आई मीन इट्स अल्टीमेट बॉयज ओन एडवेंचर टाइप ऑब्वियसली मस्ट बी रेड इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द टाइम दैट इट वाज रिटन इन clarification. Big clarification there. But I feel like if they're handing out the premier award for comedy in his name, it's okay to still read him.
Yeah. That's
so
true.
That is my thought. But yeah, Huck Finn was like a great like adventure book. Like
same. Yeah.
And I just love that they were companion pieces, right? Tom Sawyer and Huck Finn. It was the TCU, the Twain Cinematic Universe. And I think that was cool to see. Any recommendations on social and gender parity?
Gender parity.
Social parity, I mean, you can't say it without, of course, saying, please read Annihilation of Caste. Thank you. Please read Annihilation of Caste by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. Very important book, especially
I just, like, this weekend gifted Annihilation of Caste to Srimoy and Prashasti.
Oh, beautiful.
Because I really like these are some of the books I really want everyone to read.
Oh, 100%.
No, I should definitely 100%. It's on my list. I should definitely read
100%. Gender parity. I don't know about parity, but for example, one book that I read that was very eye opening for me was Hunger by Roxane Gay, and would 100% recommend that book to everybody. Do you guys have any recommendation?
On gender parity.
Nah, man.
Nah.
Like, I mean, wo, not, it's all very basic shit, yaar. It's so nothing interesting that's coming to mind.
Thank you, Piyush Pandey, for your chat. I'm assuming this is not the Piyush Pandey.
Maybe it is.
Maybe it is. In that case, thank you, Mr. Piyush Pandey, for your chat. Amazing stream with thoda handke view on things. Please also do movie related bits like Royal Turd shows. That's right, guys. The stream is now advertising industry approved.
Royal Turds kar rahe hain pe. Q cards pade honge kahin pe main nikal ke.
Ha, matlab kahin pe to pade honge.
Na, sunna hai aapko 2011 ka Vivek Oberoi joke.
more questions. How many questions? Amruta D wants to know, have you guys read the Enid Blyton series? I mean, of course.
When you are a child in 80s and 90s, there is nothing else to read.
Yeah, so you read stories of five friends who go and solve mysteries. Apparently, did you know that the biggest problem with police work is that the police don't go on enough picnics? Like, my fundamental belief after reading Enid Blyton is that the fundamental problem with policing in this world is that the police don't go on enough picnics, because what we have learned is if you go on enough picnics, mysteries will just fall into your lap and they will also get solved.
You're a child and you are closer to the ground.
Or the other mistake. The other mistake in policing is that all police should be kids. one or the other.
Last year about like people finding her like racist.
Not just last year. Enid Blyton's always, like, for example, the characters of the Gollywogs who were in her books, they were essentially deeply terrible portrayals of, like, you know, people from Africa. Like, terrible portrayals. But again, it's a product of its time.
Dude, Einstein was racist. Ab kya karega? Matlab, kya tu GPS nahi use karega? Einstein was racist.
Gandhi in his early years had, like, very racist.
But because somebody mentioned Enid Blyton, I don't know how it goes. Can we please take a moment to talk about the food?
Of course. Scones and sandwiches and clotted cream.
Yeah, and also the non-veg, the potted meat. And I was like, this must be amazing. Apparently, it's not.
I too have consumed a lot of potted meat.
But yeah, it was quite outstanding. Khana unka bahut acha lagta tha. And it's an achievement for them to make English food sound really amazing.
This is true. That is the mark of a good writer. You made English food sound appealing. That's a hugely important thing. Arpit Khatri wants to know. Thank you, Arpit, for your chat. Any recommendation?
Malritars, though. Very nice. Yes.
Yes, Malritars also. Any recommendations to understand stand-up comedy or comedic writing better?
Ashishakya.
Shakya's column.
Have you guys read books about stand-up by stand-up comics?
Not me. I bought 2-3 books last year when I was traveling.
Correct.
I haven't started reading them at all. Like, I bought a book by Lenny Bruce, one by Carlin. I haven't started reading them.
The only book I can think of that comes to mind, which sort of gave me some insight into sort of comedic writing a little bit, was Steve Martin's Bond Standing Up. Just from the perspective of sort of just how he sort of blazed his own path. I thought that was a very interesting, but I don't really see stand-up as a very learn by reading a book sort of thing. There's also this book that Veer Das gave me. I think I very guiltily must say that it's somewhere on the shelf still. It's called I Killed. It's called I Killed and it's stories on the road, basically of comics bombing.
That's awesome.
That's very nice reading that book, because you're like, chalo, not alone.
Yeah.
It's happened to the greatest.
I have something, this title is the opposite of that, which is I'm Dying Up Here.
Nice.
By William, I'm forgetting his last name. Or something like that. I'm Dying Up Here is a book. It's recommended by a lot of comics. It's a history of like the comedy scene from like the 70s, the Comedy Store in LA. So like a lot of famous comics. have an appearance in it in that sense.
Okay.
But if you want to read, sorry, Tina Fey Bossy Pants padlo in life.
Oh, Bossy Pants is great.
It's not like about stand up, but
yeah, but Bossy Pants is great insight into at least the life in stand up.
Yeah, yeah, Tina Fey, dude. Come on.
Like,
yeah,
also Tina. True. Tina Fey.
One book by stand up comedian that I love is Sign Language by Seinfeld. I read it long time back in my college. Like,
oh, nice.
Version, and now I have a hard copy as well. Sign Language is very funny. Very, very Seinfeld humor.
Sign Language, there we go.
S-E-I-N, like
funny. Abhishek Vats, thank you for your chat for 100 rupees. He wants to know, what are your thoughts on Yuganta by Iravati Karve? And what are your thoughts on Mein Kampf? Mein Kampf, personally, not a fan of the adaptation. Yeah. Not a fan of the real life adaptation.
Not a fan of the book club also.
Not a fan of the book club either. Yes, true, true. Yeah. Usually not my favorite book club. That is going to be our answer. Rather firmly. What's your take?
But a very boring book. Like, if you're legit, just judging it as a book. Two verbose. In the sense that he just rambles, obviously.
No, Hitler rambled? No. 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 Piyush has a further question. Piyush Pandey, what's your take on the similarity between Indian comics and Western comics like Batman, Dhruv, Dogga, Punisher, Fighter Toads, Ninja Turtles, Iron Man, Inspector Steel? Also, which is better, Poirot or Sherlock? I'm going to say Sherlock because Sherlock came first.
It's more fun. It just seems very fun.
Very fun. I don't know about the similarity. I mean, obviously, yes, there was an era where we had certain characters that were knockoffs on what was already obviously popular characters and even not so popular characters. Like, if I'm not mistaken, there was an Indian comic book character called Anthony, who was essentially supposed to be our version of the Crow. I'm not even making this up. It's supposed to be our version of the Crow, as in like the comic book slash the brand indie movie, The Crow. It was supposed to be our version of that. But there were also so many differences, right? Like, I dare you to show me an American comic book where the biggest superhero is just an uncle. Just a very smart uncle. Yeah. That's it. Like, that's it. It's the most Indian thing I can imagine. That there is one patronizing Dadaji that knows everything. And he is the greatest superhero in our pantheon.
And he just hangs out with the guy from Jupiter who wears a chanti.
And that's it. Can't do without some casual everyday Indian sexism of his. Of course, beats the greatest criminals in the world, but is afraid of Bini Auntie, his wife.
Yeah.
Also, now that we're talking about this, did you guys know, I found out recently, very recently, in fact, when all this drugs in Bollywood was happening, that Chacha Chaudhary is now very much that side of the spectrum. The page on Facebook, the official page, has all of these, I think, Daily Comics or something it was. Basically, just Chacha Chaudhary reacting to all of these developments in the news. Very much on the wrong side of the
story. No!
So,
Chacha!
Gaya.
Chacha's brain is still on Windows 95 computer! Oh no, when Sabu get angry, FIR get filed somewhere. Lalavino OP.
I didn't read much of Western comics growing up. Right. Like I know you, like especially you, Rohan, have read a lot of them. But I loved Hindi comics.
Oh, 100%. I remember so many train journeys with just stacks of Chacha Chaudhary. Like stacks.
Yeah.
Chacha Chaudhary, all of that.
Fauladi Singh, bro. Fauladi Singh. Don't forget Fauladi Singh.
Super Commander 2. Sorry.
Yeah, I was coming to that. One zone of Chacha Chaudhary, Makelal, Pinky, Bablu. That zone. There was one Super Commando Dhruv, Nagra, Doga, Parpani. Yeah. Lot of fun. Super Commando 2, I was a big fan of it. Super Commando 2 was too good.
Yeah, Super Commando Dhruv was truly really excellent.
Like proper superhero movies of these comics.
So Rohan, sorry, are you on? We have questions left, right?
I have lots of questions. Wait.
I've seen some interesting ones in the chat. That's why.
Yes. Kaushal Joshi wants to know, what is your opinion on Khalid Hosseini's books?
I was just going to ask. Shweta Singh also asked that.
Yes, Kaushal Joshi also wants to know on the super chat, what is your opinion on Khalid Hosseini's books? I like Khalid Hosseini's books while I'm reading them, but I also find the core of them to be a little emotionally manipulative, which I'm not such a huge fan of.
Yeah, I read the first one because it was so highly regarded, The Kite Runner.
Yeah.
And fucking difficult book to read, but sure. And then I read the synopsis for Thousand Splendid Suns and I'm like,
Like
I read
Thousand Splendid Suns even.
Like it's good in that sad porn space.
Huh. It's basically a little bit that.
Yeah. I remember even I was reading it on a train journey on like upper berth, kite runner, started crying. It's too much. Like for you 1,000 times over. Oh my god, Aurora.
Yeah. That's damn that. For you 1,000 times over is just like the saddest, most heartbreaking. Manas Ambekar, thank you for your chat. What are your favorite history books? KVOP. I think we answered this. Ankit Israni asked thoughts on Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl. We did not have strong opinions on the subject. Tapan Kamath has an interesting and important question as we come close. Last 3-4 questions. How much / often do you guys read? I often feel like there's so much to read, but too little time, especially with shows, movies, games. Tapan, welcome to the eternal dilemma, Tapan. Tapan, welcome to the eternal dilemma of just too much and not enough time. Absolutely.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Absolutely, 100% agree. Like, the amount of reading that happened in those years where these, you know, Netflix, YouTube, smartphone hadn't come. And we could buy books.
Yes.
Those years. Oh my God, the number of books that we used to read. Like every journey was just an excuse to read books. Like,
oh, absolutely.
Like, dude. Oh, acha, whatever. Cannot place se Dwarka. Yeah, bring it on. Like, okay. Full 1 hour you'll just read.
Now, of course.
Yo, I can totally relate to it.
Dude, bachpan mein agar koi meko bolta ki tu do button dabayega Kindle pe, book aa jayega, tu kabhi bhi padh sakta hai. But you don't have like Netflix and all that shit, whatever. Like, I'd be like, that's fine. Like,
yeah, that's totally fine. That would have been totally fine. I would have been okay in a world that just had that.
My trick, this is not successful because I have no discipline. Hmm. But I try, the Kindle lies on my pillow every night and I try to read some of it every night so that main kuch to padh lun and I'm not staring at Reddit till morning, like 4 in the morning. But that's the only like closest I've gotten.
Yeah, but that actually makes it worse because now I associate reading with just falling asleep. So it's usually 5-6 pages and then I'm out and that's horrible. Like, yeah. So I try to now get into bed early before I'm a little too sleepy.
So then I can do
some reading before I fall asleep. Yeah. Otherwise, it happens.
Try for an hour at least or whatever.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But here's the thing. If you read something fun, then you're like, fuck it.
Then you're screwed. Exactly. Then you're screwed. If it's super engaging, you're screwed. You can't win, no? Yeah. Then you can't win. Sorry, super chats. Smriti Joshi wants to know, have you read Tuesdays with Maury? Sweet light read. Yes, agreed. It is a sweet light read. Confection, basically. Ninad Kothawade says, highly recommend The Martian. Hitchhiker's Guide and Ready Player One is audiobooks, I believe, especially The Martian works best as an audiobook. Thank you for that recommendation. It's a really, really good one.
Martian works good as a video book also.
This is true. He is very good.
Hitchhiker's didn't quite work as a video book, but
it's okay. Like, what? Maninder Kang wants to know, what book you read this year that has impacted you on a personal level? Doesn't have to be non-fiction. Dil pe kaunsi lagi?
Book that I read this year.
Oh, let me just look at my list right now. 1 second. Yeah. One book I really enjoyed, I mean, impact on personal level and all is a bit much to ask because we are all jaded, made of stone. So, abhi thoda mushkil hota hai.
Uh-huh.
But I think I really liked, How to Get Filthy Rich in Rising Asia by Hanif Mohammed.
Okay.
That's a really good book.
Oh, okay.
I mean, abhi recently padhi hai.
On that note, A Case of Exploding Mangoes, I highly, highly recommend.
Haan. Excellent book. Excellent book.
One book I read this year that I loved is a book by Ravish Kumar called Ishq Mein Sheher Rona. It's very embarrassing and I'm working on this topic is that I've never read Hindi books. You know what I mean? I really want to. So one of my agendas in my reading life now is to go back and read all these books by Premchand, etc., like Manto, etc. Mm-hmm. Someone gifted me the English translation of Ishq Mein Sheher Rona. Okay. And I started reading, and I think Vishal Dayam, I think he came to my house. And he's like, ye to English mein kyun pad raha hai? I'm like, I'll give you the Hindi version. I have it.
Yeah. And
it's beautiful.
Reading Ravish in English would just do injustice to that. That man's when he speaks, you just want to listen. Like, even like what I like, Ravish, even when he gives bad news, nah, I'm like, sunaiye Ravish. Sunaiye. Sunaiye, koi baat nahi. Sunte hain.
Dekho, corona ki mahamari pure duniya mein phail chuki hai. Oh, apne muh par mask laga kar ghume hain, sir.
Oh, Ravish ji, aur Ravish ji.
So, speaking of Hindi books and this translation thing, again, I have the same problem.
Agreed. 100% guilty. Should read way more.
A few years ago, I picked up Javed Akhtar's Quiver or Tarkash.
Yeah.
And it comes with the book that I have has the Hindi version in the script, Devanagari, or side notes ka English translation.
Dude. Paran ke liye.
But there is no comparison. The Hindi one is so Hindi Urdu.
Oh, of course, of course, of course. Oh. You can, dude, you can tell so many times, and just when they, even with contextual, right? Like now we finally got into contextual subtitles on Hindi dialogue. And even then, there are times where you're just like, nah. Like even something as stupid as, there is no English equivalent of Lodu Lalit.
Yeah. Like, Prachand Chutiye ko aap nahi kar sakte.
Nahi, nahi, no chance. No chance. And, like somewhere some British guy can try and he'll probably come up with something. But,
Sorry, and this is shout out to Rohan, because if you ask about like great books that I've read this year, your recommendation, dude, I've spoken about it before, Three Body Problem.
Oh, and too much best. Club,
that is the closest I'll get to like fucking what a punch in the face.
That is like full head explosion.
Yeah.
That is maximum head explosion. The book I've read this year that has changed my life is actually a cookbook called Salt, Fat, Acid, Heat by Sameen Nusrat. And I'm not just saying that in a funny way, but because she really breaks food down into its key constituent elements of salt, fat, acid, heat. That's what she breaks cooking down into. And she takes you on this journey where she explains to you why each four of these ingredients are important before she ever gets to a recipe. And she breaks it down scientifically and very lucidly. It's like reading Cosmos for food. And by the time you reach the end of that section, it's not just about recipes. You know the basics of how cooking works enough that you're just more confident in the kitchen when you go in with anything. Like it's just, and it's a beauty. The illustrations by Wendy McNaughton, so beautiful. Like I'll show you some of them at some point, and oh my god, they are staggering. So staggering. So that is the book that changed my this thing. We are done with 30 questions, but we have a couple of super chat questions that we have to get to. Abhinav Chandekar wants to know, how do you guys strike a balance between consuming and creating? Balance, beta wo kya hota hai?
देखो अभी तो सिर्फ कंज्यूम ही हो रहा है सर.
हाँ वही तो.
हाँ मतलब
कंज्यूमिंग ही तो हो रहा है. ऑल कंज्यूमिंग.
केवी केवी डू हैव एन आंसर. आई थिंक यू हैव क्रिएटेड
बिजी भाई अगेन. क्या ही क्रिएट कर रहे
तू तो क्विज क्रिएट कर रहा है यार इतने सारे.
कोई आके बुला लेता है तो कुछ उसके बहाने हमारा हो जाता है क्रिएट. इट्स लाइक व्हेन यू आर शूटिंग इट्स लाइक ओके समवन एल्स हैज डन एवरीथिंग. आई जस्ट
हां हां. Ribu Ghosh wants to know, have you guys read P.G. Woodhouse and Sidney Sheldon? Yes and yes. Both have their treats. P.G. Woodhouse still king of a good insult, sarcastic insult. And Sidney Sheldon, very good at making you turn pages.
Yeah.
It's a talent.
Woodhouse, very funny. And
oh, very funny. Very funny. Like,
it's so difficult.
Like
to be
individual sentences of such spectacularness, right? Just individual statements that are so spectacular.
Yeah. Yeah, and Sidney Sheldon masterclass in page turning, like you said, like, I mean, we all remember those days.
Yeah, of course, of course, of course. It's like literally, it is the Tara of books, right? Like where the doorbell rang at the end of the chapter. Next chapter, mein postman tha. Theek hai. But
nobody in the chat got that reference.
It's okay, it's fine. There'll be some old person who'll get it eventually. They'll watch it one day. This will be syndicated on CNN, IBN. As an 11 p.m. show, and then there'll be some 60-year-old who'll watch and be like, oh, I got that reference. Again, Piyush Pandey says, this is an interesting one. Thank you for your chat. How do you envision Song of Ice and Fire novels ending with R.R. Martin still writing Winds of Winter and Dream of Spring?
Yeah, I keep forgetting that there are two left. I
don't know. Yeah, not one. There are two left.
Yeah, I know. I hope like, they will do justice to people like Daenerys. They'll do justice to the basic plot line and development. Honestly,
I hope he just continues to behave like the show doesn't exist. Like that's one thing I like about the books, because they largely came out before the show. I just hope he continues to behave like the show does not exist and just gives, like you said, just gives his characters the dignity they deserve all the way through to the end. Like that's it. Simple.
I'm okay with her turning into a mad queen, but like show me some logic.
As opposed to it happening in 14 minutes.
Yeah.
In 14 minutes. So that is the answer. KV, do you have any thoughts?
No. I agree. Totally agree with you. Yeah. Otherwise, there's no point to writing those two books. You know?
None. If it's going to end exactly the way the show ended.
What's the point?
There's no point. Just drew a one-page graphic novel and finish it. Aditya Vishnu, have you read Love Will Find a Way by Anurag Garg? If you haven't, please do read. Thank you, Aditya Vishnu, for the chat and for the recommendation. Ananya, I found The Great Gatsby very slow and kind of boring. I also think it is slightly overrated. Slightly. And with that, I think, let me just go through once to make sure I've not missed any super chats. Any Saurabh wants to know any manga recommendations. I'm not a huge manga reader, so I would not be the person to ask that.
Not read.
Same. Ill.
Sorry, V is too old. Bhairavi Bhagat wants to know, what's your take on the Clifton series by Jeffrey Archer? Thank you for the recommendations. Really interested by some of these. I have not read the Clifton series. What is the Clifton series?
You know, I think I have the first one. I wanted a light read, so I think it's lying around somewhere in the house. Kisi ki padi hai. Not read it though. Yeah, it seems interesting. It seems like one of those generational sort of sagas. It seems interesting.
Drupal Ashar, who's also sent a super chat, says, great stuff, guys. I would like to throw some light to the manga, especially One Piece, which has been running for 22 years now, and its world building is amazing. Thank you, Drupad, for using your super chat to answer a question from another super chat. That really solves my life and sorts it out. But One Piece, I have heard amazing things about. For sure. Lolamino OP. Question for Varun. What does he do when he has an interesting anecdote to share, but people around him are like, fir chalu ho gaya?
Pick and choose like what anecdote to share in what setting and not just randomly go about like, oh, Jeffrey Archer to aisa hai, ek bar usko jail ho gaya tha, like I don't do that.
Yes.
Archer is an IPL player, like why?
Oh. At the end of his auction, they said not a penny more, not a penny less.
Not a
P.S. wants to know, surely you're joking, Mr. Feynman. Padhaya, maine nahi padhaya, lekin suna hai aur suna hai ke bahut mast hai.
Yeah. Padhaya, highly recommend.
Padhaya, highly recommend. Done. KV recommended is gold standard recommended.
Highly recommend.
Surat Subhraveti says, another recommendation for social equality, the perspective being US centric, is the new Jim Crow. From an Indian perspective, Caste Matters by Suraj Yengde. Yes, absolutely. I would love to have Suraj Yengde on this chat one day. I feel like that would be a lot of fun. For sure. And with that, I think we have done it, guys. I think we have made it to the end. And that's about it. Yeah, we have made it. We have made it to the end, guys.
Awesome.
We have answered 30 questions. Before we wrap this up, and I say thank you to both of you, I will also ask both of you before you go to recommend one book each, please, aside from everything that has already been recommended, because I feel like over the course of the last hour, you've definitely recommended something and then gone, oh fuck, I should have recommended that. So this is the place to right those wrongs and clear that slate and recommend as many things as you want before we go.
I'm just looking at my list of my kya padha hai recently.
Because you have to ask, recommend one or two or three, because then we'll not end.
Like, yeah, okay, fair. Okay, recommend three.
Three.
Okay. Okay, we go.
Oh, I'll go first. Okay. Apart from, so the filter is that those books we have not mentioned in the last.
Yes.
What happened?
Yes.
Okay. We can go whenever anyone has.
Okay. I can go with one. Everybody Lies by Seth Stephens Davidowitz, which is about basically big data and how you can use it and also how it's terrifying. And it is basically, I think, the book for our times. It's called Everybody Lies by Seth Stephens Davidowitz.
Okay, let's go as a clockwise, like quizzing, infinite ones.
Yes.
I would go with Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime. Fun, simple, like I love it.
Beautiful, beautiful book. Beautiful book. Mr. Shakya.
Okay, so now because people asked, I really like that question about non-readers, readers. I would recommend this thoroughly entertaining page turner called Dark Matter by Blake Crouch. It is one of those, like each chapter is 3 minutes, 4 minutes.
And nice.
It's one of those. And it's very pop sci-fi. Like if you've seen the show Fringe, it's very much in that space. It's very pop sci-fi, but nicely entertaining and thoda sa halka sa. Thoda sa emotional core bhi hai.
Nice.
And I mean, it's one of those like I finished it in a night, like 4 hours or whatever. Dark Matter by Blake Crouch. It's a thriller. It's
Dark Matter by Blake Crouch. That's the one.
One.
Okay, me again. Oh shit. Pressure. Oh, yep. Good. Saved by my shelf right here. Pull it out.
The one day I needed my bookshelf behind me.
Yeah, really? You really need your bookshelf behind you today, buddy. I would 1,000,000%. Shax. You know about this. I don't know if you guys can see it.
Oh,
see
yeah, I've heard
Matterhorn about it. By Carl Malantes. It's called Matterhorn. The author is Carl Malantes, who used to be a Marine. And it's basically, it's a fictionalized version of his tour of duty in Vietnam. And it is, And then this is not a sentence I ever thought I would say in my life, but it like, it blows Platoon out of the water. Like it blows Platoon, Apocalypse Now, wow, everything just far out of the water. It is an astonishing story. Like, yeah, tremendous. And it's everything, all right? It's got the actual horrors of war. It's got the whole Band of Brothers bonding. It's got all the race tension that was going on in America back then that was getting translated between sort of African-American soldiers and non-African-American soldiers and the camps that were forming as a result of that. It is freaking intense and amazing, this book. And I would 1,000,000% recommend it.
Wow.
KV.
My turn. Since people are talking about history, I would recommend Freedom at Midnight.
Okay.
Freedom at Midnight, if anyone wants to know more about India's freedom and events surrounding it, particularly partition, it's a wonderful, wonderful book. A lot of us have heard of it but haven't read it. So I would highly recommend Dominic Clapier's Freedom at Midnight.
Okay, Freedom at Midnight. So far we've got Freedom at Midnight. Ashish, yours was, we got Curious Incident of Dog in the Nighttime. Shax, you were Dark Matter. I have said Everybody Lies and I have said Matterhorn, and it is your turn for one more book.
Mine?
Yes.
Okay. Again, this is a genre I enjoy, and it's non-fiction, but it's very exciting non-fiction. It's called Double Cross by Ben McIntyre, who is a historian. And it is the story of the largest espionage deception operation behind the D-Day landings. It was a massive, massive operation.
Double cross
by Ben McIntyre. Hitler was led to believe that attack ek jagah aega and it came the other way.
Yeah.
And like the industrial strength effort it went. It is said that Britain at that point owned or had turned all the German agents in Britain. They had turned them into double agents. So there were five key people who were the thrust of this operation. Like civilians, most of them, and it is outstanding, their story and what like regular people have done in that war, and just, I mean, super, super book.
Extraordinary. Chalo. Okay, one more. Humid Slain Kit, thank you for the super chat. Congrats on Vegan Bakes, with plenty relatable. You three are awesome. It is true. I agree. This has been a very, very fun panel. I think that's actually enough. Two recommendations. We've given people six recommendations plus the entire stream. Thank you so much, everybody, for being on this stream. Thank you so much for all of this. Thank you, KV, for giving us an hour and a half of your valuable, genial time. It has been a pleasure, as always. Mr. Shakya, good luck for your newsletter. Do you want to tell us about it one more time before we go?
Yeah.
Yes. It's called Stupidus Maximus 2.0. It's on ashishakya.substack.com. It's weekly humor columns. If you've read my blog, if you've read the Hindustan Times columns, or if you've enjoyed like my or our comedy over the years, you'll get that on a weekly basis in your inbox. Plus, there's lots of bonus features. You'll get access to live events that I'm going to do once in a while, and community access and hang out with other readers and all that.
Yeah,
stuff.
Guys, this is the closest Ashish is going to get to an OnlyFans account. So,
yeah. Hey, how do you know I don't already have one?
Because I looked, Ashish.
And yeah, so if you're going to subscribe, I would suggest go for the monthly subscription. It's 149 rupees a month. And
amazing. Thank you, friends. This has been fun. I'm going to end the stream now. Thank you, everybody, for watching. Thank you all for your super chats. And we'll be back, of course, next Thursday with another stream and also a bunch of other fun content coming out next week. So peace out. Good night. Shubh Ratri, etc. All of that.